Now that we've seen how to do some basic statistical calculations and how to handle missing values, let's try to visualize some of the data by making some basic plots. There are a number of built-in plots that are just included as a part of the basic R package. They're extremely easy to use, but they are somewhat limited because of your ability to customize them. There is actually an extremely popular graphics package called the ggplot2 library. And the ggplot2 library is part of the tidyverse package. So I mentioned tidyverse before as a bunch of related packages that typically involve tuples. So if you download the entire tidyverse, you will get ggplot2 along with it. The description of it is that it embodies a deep philosophy of visualization. So the using the ggplot function is actually rather complicated because you have many, many different aspects of the visualization that are under your control. The result is you end up with a highly customizable plot, but there is also quite much of a greater learning curve to learning how to make plots in ggplot than using the built-in plots. So in this lesson, because it's a beginner lesson, we're not going to be talking about ggplot. We will actually cover that later in an entire series of lessons on its own. The first of the built-in functions that we're going to look at is the histogram function, hist. All it does is you pass in a vector and it shows you the distribution of the data that is in that vector in the form of a histogram. And you'll see it in the lower right pane of our studio. Since I've cleared out my global environment, let's read the human heights data back in again, just to refresh our memories. Here's what it looks like, 14 values with 7 heights of men and 7 heights of women. If we perform the histogram function on it, we see that it creates a histogram of the human heights. It's not a very smooth distribution because there's only 14 points in it. If we look at a larger data set, for example, if we read in the schools data set again and make a histogram of it, we can see that we have a much smoother curve because there are many more schools included in the data set. So what the data shows you is the distribution of schools by number of female students. There are a small number of schools that have a lot of female students and a small number that have a few, but most schools have between about 100 and 300 females within the school. Each time we create a plot in the plot window over here, the old plots that are in there are still there and we can pass back and forth between them using these arrows. So here's my first plot and here is my second plot. If you accumulate a lot of plots, you can step through them one at a time using these arrows.